Very good morning, everybody. If you go to any corporate today, if you go to any strategic leader today, if you just imagine that you bump into a boardroom and randomly at any point in time, I would say 85% of the time you would hear these three words from the CEO's speech. One is innovation, being innovative. Second is business transformation, and third is the artificial intelligence. Okay, the world around us today talking about innovation. In other words, it is also talking about being creative. In my view, I would even say that the world has gone beyond a creative economy to something what I call as creator's economy. So what is the difference between a creative economy and creator's economy? A creative economy is an economy when you have 100 companies, 100 individuals, out of which maybe 2-3% are thinking out of the box. When you're looking at a creator's economy, there is a desperate need for every individual, every employee in the company in the industry, and every citizen in a nation, and every nation in the world to think creatively. That is the need of the hour to transform this entire world. And that's the generation, that's the challenge that what the next generation has to face when you're looking at hunting jobs. So coming back to this, the title of innovation, blue ocean strategy, and what is called as Thiruvalluvar. Let me also take some time to introduce myself. My name is Prabhu Swaminathan, and I am the founder of the training brand called AFMOI, which is pronounced as AFMOI. And the expansion of that is Academy for Market Orientation India. We are a purpose-driven organization, and we have a great vision to take the employability of a state called Tamil Nadu in India to number one in the next 5 years. So that's a brief introduction about me. So coming back to the core topic of innovation, and one of the highly spoken, celebrated, and appreciated business innovation strategy framework is something called Blue Ocean Strategy, which was developed by Kim, which has been developed based on a research of more than 100 companies in the last two centuries. And what is this Blue Ocean Strategy all about, and how it is related to something called Thirukkural or a Thiruvalluvar? Blue Ocean Strategy is nothing but it says as simple as that: if don't look at industry as your benchmarks, beat the industry, make the competition irrelevant. And if you think innovation is risky, if you think innovation is abstract, why not you derive a formula or create a framework so that your abstract component of innovation and the risk component of innovation is mitigated. So Blue Ocean came out with a framework, something called ERRC, which means eliminate, reduce, raise, and create. What E and R means? E and R means, it says, eliminate and reduce certain factors which the industry has been continuously giving it to the customers, but it doesn't make no sense, or it does make less sense to the customer. So eliminate and reduce those factors. And there is a cost attached to it. So by eliminating and reducing those factors which the industry has been continuously giving, but it doesn't make any impact, you have a cushion to play with. Second, raise and create certain factors which the industry hasn't thought about, or the industry has been giving a minimal level, where if you raise those values to the customers, you break the industry trend, you create a new trend, and that's how you create a Blue Ocean strategy. So Blue Ocean always talks about non-compete, being unique, and making the competition irrelevant. And it also has the six-path framework and three tiers of non-customers and the tipping point leadership and so on and so forth. But having said that, Blue Ocean in simple terms talks about how to be unique, risk-free, beat time, and stay away from the competition and make the competition irrelevant. I had an opportunity, or rather I would say I was given an opportunity, to take this Blue Ocean concept to small and medium entrepreneurs in the tier 2 and the tier 3 cities of my state called Tamil Nadu. So in the last 1 year, I would say we have been conducting workshops on this Blue Ocean strategy. In fact, we are a purpose-driven organization. We wanted to take all such heavy concepts, both in the academia, to the student level, and to the entrepreneur level, okay, who are in the smaller towns, and revolutionize and transform and create a creative mindset in the minds of those people in the tier 2 and tier 3 cities. And that is how we can actually create real, what I spoke in the beginning, something called a creator's economy, which can transform this entire world. Okay, so coming back to this, when I was given an opportunity to do something about this, I thought VAR could be the perfect example in my surroundings to even make them relate and understand. Then I found this book called Thirukkural, and I have my mother tongue is Tamil, and I have my affinity and I would say even passion towards my mother tongue called Tamil for two or three simple reasons. One, it's my mother tongue. Second, the pedigree, the history, the origin of this language and the respect that it has in the global level. So without getting into the language part of it, I want to say that how this book is going to be unique. This book called Thirukkural dates back to 300 BC to 300 BCE, and this was written by somebody called Thiruvalluvar, who competed with 450 poets during this 300 BC to 300 BCE, and this duration is called a Sangam period in Tamil literature, which means a Sangam means confluence, where a group of poets will come and sing songs, gather, create songs and meet together in a particular place and display their competencies and the scriptures. And in fact, invariably we had this culture, and it is said there are three Sangams: the first Tamil Sangam, the second Tamil Confluence and the third Tamil Sangam during the Pandya's era in the Tamil Nadu, headquartered in Madurai. So coming back to this Thiruvalluvar, in my view, I thought, why not, if he has written a book, something which stands apart for 2000 years, when we are talking about a blue ocean strategy which makes the companies to stand apart, why not this blue ocean framework be adapted or probably incorporated by Thiruvalluvar by that time? So I just thought, in what way this book is unique? Can we apply ER and RC for Thirukkural? From that way, I just wanted to tell you what were the traditional poets doing by the time and what did this Thiruvalluvar do uniquely. The traditional poets by the time, this 400-450 poets, they were praising the lords, they were praising the kings, they were praising the particular person, or if they cannot do all of things, they were praising themselves. Okay, so there were a lot of individuality, a lot of particularity, there were a lot of heroism, there were a lot of devotions, and there were a lot of specific topics around which these poems have been written. But Thiruvalluvar, if this is the industry by the time, if this was the industry by the time, this Thiruvalluvar broke this entire myth. You know what? He completely eliminated this particularity, individuality, heroism and whatnot. Second, what did he reduce? Okay, imagine this the other industry was writing big poems which consumed lots and lots of pages. By the time, pages were palm leaves. Thiruvalluvar very smartly came out with something called the 4+3 concept. Okay, first line four words and second line four words. Okay, which is called as even called Kural Venba in our Tamil. Okay, so it actually reduced the consumption of palm leaves. Okay, second, when the terse is short and sweet, when the poem is short and sweet, your brain processing time, anybody who knows the short term memory and the long term memory and the critical thinking concept will understand anything which is short and sweet with simplified words, easily understandable words is what he used. He reduced the complexity of the words by the time. Okay, so he reduced the complexity of the words, he reduced the consumption of palm leaves, and thereby he has followed the concept of reduction also. So what did he actually raise? Okay, he actually raised something called recollectability, because he used simple words which were so easy to recollect by the time, and so he raised the recollectability, and he also raised something called the phonics, which was if you actually see, the Thirukkural can be sung as a song. It's a beautiful way of singing as a song. So he raised the since it is short and sweet and only four in the top and three in the bottom, I would say you can beautifully sing a song using the phonics of those times. So what did he actually create? Three things he created. The Venba, what is called as the 4+3 concept, which is one of the toughest format of Tamil grammar by which you can write a poem. Okay, so he created something called Kural Venba, the short and sweet, four in the top and the three in the bottom. Two, if you read his things, there are beautiful ways of using metaphor. Usually I have seen poems where metaphor will be used in the top and metaphor's interpretation would be in the second line or a third line. This gentleman has created something. He just created a poem only metaphor, and he left to the interpretation of the readers very open. Okay, there are poems only with metaphor. Okay, and readers can interpret in whatever they, you know, format they want and context they want. And third, the usage of words. You know, a particular word in any language is likely to have at least minimum two meanings. But Thiruvalluvar used it very beautifully in a lot of Thirukkurals, where a particular word having multiple meanings will be used in the same Thirukkural itself. In that way, multiple meanings of the words, were so creatively used to attract the end users. So if I have to do a very, very simple analogy between a blue ocean strategy, what has been built by the Kim and Thirukkural today, I would say 2000 years back, you know, without knowing this, the risk-free format of what is called as the much celebrated blue ocean, this gentleman has adapted this blue ocean framework inherently without his knowledge. And that's one of the reasons. Today, if you're talking about, blue ocean and implementation, any blue ocean after a particular period of time is likely to become a red ocean. But this gentleman's work of Thirukkural is standing apart. Is standing apart not for 1 year, is standing apart not for 2 years, but for thousands of years, but for 2000 years, only because he has understood, if we have to create something which lasts for 2000 years to 2500 years, you have to be completely different. It has to be completely unique. It has to completely stand apart. It has to be, and it has to come under the realm of what I discussed in the beginning, something called not only being creative, but being a creator's economy. In my view, Thirukkural and Thiruvalluvar, as though it dates back to 2500 years, in my view, he understood the need of creativity. He understood the need of being unique. He understood the concept of, creator's economy. And that is one of the reasons I would say Thirukkural is translated in most of the languages across the world, and it is also called as Ulaga Podumarai, which means, the world's common moral book. It doesn't talk about any religion or any particular god for that matter. So I would say let's all celebrate we being part of such a culture, we being part of such a beautiful innovation, and let's thank this gentleman called Thiruvalluvar for being so innovative and teaching us how to be innovative 2500 years back. So hats off to this gentleman called Thiruvalluvar. Let's all be part of this creative, or rather I would say even the creator's economy, and look at adding value every day, every second and every minute from now on.